Okay, we did casino, security, vibing, tickling, and math. And here's the first video.
Sound quality is phenomenal. Why is it doing this? That's part of the video. What is going on?
Okay. Alright, let's just keep playing it. Should we restart it?
Yeah, this video is talking about how chaotic casinos normally are, how they look, and that they're not very chaotic at all, they're actually quite organized. See the rats who handcuff this man. Indiana. It's literally not me.
I think we should change this so it doesn't do two videos.
Oh, yeah.
Like show two videos right at the beginning?
Yeah, I do too. I was about to say. The other computer is not spans out like this one is.
I know. It's not our fault though, so.
No.
Okay. So there's something called NORA, and what it does is before they hire someone, they have to do a background check, make sure that the employees that they're hiring didn't do anything sketchy in their past. So they look up their education, where they live, what they used to do, and their behavioral patterns. And they have to check to make sure they do this so that sometimes the dealers will also cheat to help the players win so that they'll win tips as well. Monitoring employees. So the cameras watch for tells, and it tells a signal in a game. And the dealer gives a tell to the gambler so he'll know how to win and he can know what cards are coming up. So that's another reason why they get tips. And the dealers are required to make certain gestures so they make sure that they're counting everything correctly. And the dealers have to hold the cards at a 45 degree angle so that the cameras above can see and so that the players can see the cards. And then Angel Eye is this thing that they put in the card shoe. And what it does is it has a little barcode and it can read the cards. And so if someone takes a card and they like have it on their sleeve or something and they put it into the deck, they can find out if that's if they're cheating because that one won't have the barcode. And that's how they find that. It's called card poking. And that's a picture of the card shoe. Count rooms, this is where they have really high tech security, and to get in you have to do a fingerprint or something so they can identify you. Not that many people are allowed into there, and once you're in there, that's where you count all the money. And they use something called biometrics, so when you go in there and somehow if you pass the first door, the security, they can look at your face and they can see if you're supposed to be in there or not, and that's the facial recognition software. Used. And this is the same thing, biometrics they can also use in the regular casino card. And so if someone's banned from a casino and they decide to come back, they change their appearance, they have plastic surgery, or they're wearing colored contact lenses, they can see through that and they can find out your real identity and they can kick you out or you can go to jail or something even more serious than that. That's a picture of the card counting room. Or the counting room. Facial recognition software. I don't know what that is.
No, it's the count room.
You already did that one.
No, this is like a different.
Well, if the cheater gets recognized, they get kicked out. And if someone is playing a game and the computer picks up on the person cheating, sometimes their facial emotions will change, and so they'll know that if they were expecting a card and if they act a certain way, that they were cheating and they can pick them out for card counting or anything other than that. RFID chips are these little chips that they can put into the chips, and they can find out if you steal them, if you take them home or anything. They can find out where you are and they can track you down. They have them in $25 chips and up, and they're just monitored and tracked everywhere, and they count them at the beginning of the day and at the end of the day to make sure that none of them have left the casino. This is a man named Anthony Carleo, and he stole $1.5 million worth of chips, except he didn't know that they had the transmitter inside of it. And so when he left and he didn't cash it in at the Bellagio, they noticed. And so when they found that out, they made $1.5 million mean nothing since he stole them. So he couldn't cash it in. This is the picture of the transmitter that they put in the RFID chip. And that's a chip with the RFID. And here's the video about that.
Thank you.
so they also have to monitor the games, even though they have the surveillance cameras and everything. And so they have the people, not only all the cameras, I mean, they have the people walking around, such as the pit bosses. And the pit bosses have to watch the dealers, and they look down for choke points. And so when they have the games, and they have to walk down the aisles, and so if they do anything illegal, they have to walk down those aisles to leave the casino. And slots aren't monitored by anything other than the cameras, because the machines are the only things that pay about, so they can't cheat using their slot machines. The pit bosses have to watch 6 to 12 tables. At the smaller casinos, they only have usually one pit, and at the bigger ones, they have more than one. And they are just making sure everything runs smoothly, that the dealers aren't cheating or anything. And they usually watch craps, roulette, and poker. And they're just in charge of all the personnel in their pit. And this is a video of what the pit bosses are going to look for from the players or the dealers or anything. Does yours have any videos though?
I think I have one.
Oh, I think you, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
There will be seven.
feel like we have a lot of video on the back.
Right. We need to talk for like 6 minutes.
Is that right?
Yeah. We technically only have like what, minutes of video, 12 minutes of video?
Yeah. So there's also a little controversy about too much surveillance, because since they have the cameras everywhere, they can see everything that's happening. So when people are going to cash in or get cash and they go to the ATM screens, some people who are working behind the scenes can zoom in and look at people's passwords, and they can steal their money if they're not good people. And they can also go, and when they're at the cashier windows, they can zoom in and look at personal ID, and they can look off their driver's license, and they can get a bunch of information about the people, and they can stop them and stuff like that. So here's a video about cheating.
Want to make sure it doesn't die in 8 seconds. Well, it's still going.
If it dies, is it going to save it?
Yeah, you should stop it after this video, just in case. And then put the other batteries in.
Why don't we just stop it and then start another video?
Yeah. It doesn't, I feel like it would flash a battery button,
yeah.
Wouldn't you?
Let's just dance it then, maybe.
Yeah. We're gonna have to take some stuff out. Videos.
You think?
Well, how long is it supposed to be? 25 minutes? We're going to be way over.
How long is it been?
21 minutes and 30 seconds. And I haven't even started talking yet.
Yeah. We could always just take like a video out.
Mm-hmm. Right. If we take a video out, it's going to give me 4 more minutes to talk. Alright, we need to stop it at like 4:45.
Am I done talking?
I think so.
Sweet.
Okay. Alright, I'm gonna stop.